got you calling, but you ain't not there.
Subukan, sige lang, sige, huwag nakakatakot
lang. Ba, kaya kinakatakutan. Ba, pinuhaitin ko muna lang. Ba, sige ko, huwag mong subukan. Sige lang, sige, sige lang.
So, good afternoon, everyone. So, let's start our Componency Seminar this afternoon. Let us bow down our heads and feel the presence of the Lord. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, of the Holy Spirit, Amen. Almighty and loving Father, Creator of heaven and earth, we praise you and adore you. You are the King of Kings. We humbly ask your forgiveness for all our sins. Have mercy on us, O Lord. We have gathered here today for our Componency Seminar. Send us your Holy Spirit to be our guide and give us the wisdom to understand every topic that we are going to discuss. Enlighten our minds and let your love be upon us. All this we pray through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you with the unity in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. So in the name of the Father, Son, the Holy Spirit, Amen. So once again, welcome to Componency Seminar. So this seminar will discuss all about how to ace an interview. But before we formally start our seminar this afternoon, kindly go to menti.com and use this code. Yes, sir. Go to menti.com and use this code. 4163-7756. Go to menti.com and use the code 4163-7756. Okay? Pasok na tayo sa menti.com and use the code 41637756. So we have 135 participants. Pero konti pa lang ang nakapasok sa menti.com. So pasok na tayo. Ang code na po sa screen, nasa itaas po, 1-6-7-7-5-2. Okay, let's start our activity this afternoon. So, question number one. Answer fast to get more points. What should not be worn in a job or interview? Color coordinated attire, flashy clothes and jewelry, and watch. Saang tatlo ang hindi pwede suotin during the job interview? 3, 2, 1, time's up. The correct answer is flashy clothes and jewelry. So, pangit naman magsuot ka ng jewelry, hindi naman modeling pinupuntahan mo, kundi formal job, formal interview. Next. Next, na natin kung sino ang namuna sa leaderboard natin. Okay, so team Grahedo ang namuna. Next question. Question number 2. Answer fast to get more points. Which is the best way to follow up after an interview? Email, handwritten note, or phone call. Answer na 3, 2, 1, time's up. The correct answer is email. So, email talaga ang formal way para makapag-follow up kayo sa interviewer or sa company niyo. So, next, ano kaya anong muna sa ating leaderboard? Pa rin kaya? O naunahan na siya? Oh, si John Arthur Fernandez na nung muna. Nawala na si Kim. Question number 3. Answer fast to get more points. True or false? You should use only examples from your actual work experience to answer questions during a job interview. True or false? Time's up. The correct answer is false. So it is also important to share your experiences from areas outside sa outside offices, such as yung nag-volunteer kayo sa mga community works din, yung sa sports, and personal experiences sa relationship. So let's see kung sino ang nanguna sa leaderboard. Kung si John Arthur pa rin kaya, kung humabol si Kim. Okay, number one pa rin si John Arthur Fernandez. So correct answer na si John. Next question. Question number 4. Answer fast to get more points. True or false? The interviewer's reaction to job candidates are strongly influenced by the applicant's appearance. True or false? So, ano kayang tamang answer dyan, class? It's either true ba or false ba? 3, 2, 1. Time is up. The correct answer is true. So, first impression last talaga, basta yan talaga ang tinitingnan ng mga interviewer. So next, si John Fernandez pa rin kaya ang nanguna sa leaderboard. Yan pa rin nanguna, followed by Angie. Last question, question number 5. Answer fast to get more points. True or false? At the end of the interview, we ask about the next step in the process. Totoo bang o allowed ba na mag-ask kayo sa interviewer? True or false? 3, 2, 1. Time is up. The correct answer is true. So it is also important ask if ano talaga yung hiring process nila, or kailan ba malalaman kung hire na kayo or what. So let's see the leaderboard. Si John Fernandez pa rin kaya ang nanguna. Okay, John Fernandez pa rin ang nanguna. So congratulations, John Arthur Fernandez. You got 4,837 points. Ito yung pinakamabilis sa lahat. So, go back na tayo sa Zoom. So, but before we formally start our seminar this afternoon, reminders lang guys, kung sino yung mga hindi makapasok sa Zoom, or sino yung mga classmates ninyo na walang Zoom account, pwede live po tayo sa YouTube. And then pwede din sila doon makinig sa seminar na ito. So today, we are privileged to have the Vice President of External Relations and International Affairs Office to give us his insights on how to ace an interview. Ladies and gentlemen, a virtual applause to Dr. Rinaldo C. Castro. Sir.
Okay, it's good. Thank you. Good afternoon to our KAIN 500 students. Anong premyo doon sa nanalo ng inyong activity? Wala?
Sa ano na lang siguro, sir? Sa culmination, sir.
Oh, sige. I-type na lang ng nanalo.
Type na lang yung full name at saka yung code na lang po.
Sige, okay. Okay, again, good afternoon to our KAIN 500 students. Last session that I have with you, we talk about how are you going to prepare a winning cover letter and resume, And by this time, probably your KAID 500 facilitators have asked you to submit your sample resume and sample application letter. I have also discussed last session about how are you going to ace in your job interview. These things are very important when you're facing your screening process, when you're in a screening process. And today we're going to continue our discussion. What is in store for you today, for this afternoon, is that we're going to talk about, we're going to continue about acing your job interview, specifically focused on the nonverbal communication. We're going to talk a bit about entrepreneurship and the most exciting part, the last part of our session, which I believe is more exciting, is the mock interview. And some of you will participate, will have to volunteer and participate our mock interview. Okay? All right. So let me share my screen. All right, so here we go. So let's talk about nonverbal communication. And when you say nonverbal communication, these are non-words, no? Non-words communication. And let's find out how this nonverbal communication is also important to our interview, in facing a job interview, and how this influence the hiring officer or the interviewer, their decision, no? Especially in finally deciding who among the applicants will be hired, all right? There are three sets of cues important in job interview. One is vocal, no? So you adjust your voice. If you think that your voice has a tingling sound, you adjust that, no? You practice recording your voice and you listen to your voice and you practice the rhythm, the tone of your voice. The second one is physical appearance, and I think it came out in the activity this afternoon, no? The mentee activity, something about the first impression that lasts. And it's true, no? The first thing that, you know, the interviewer will see from an applicant will actually influence and will give an impression about the personality, the potential of that person who will be about to be interviewed. The third one is your body movement, your gestural, no? Even in your, if you're in a remote virtual interview, no, especially if you're in a face-to-face interview, your gestures and your body movement are very important because it speaks something about how do you feel the time, what is your feeling, what's your emotion, whether you're relaxed, whether you're tense, or whether you're, you know, there are crocodiles and dinosaurs in your stomach the time. All right. So let's talk about this nonverbal communication. It says here that the evaluation of your nonverbal communication starts as soon as you walk into the company's lobby and continue until the interviewer is finished. No? And in fact, most companies, take note of that, most companies, if you're in a face-to-face interview, they have installed CCTV in the lobby. And while you are waiting for your turn to be interviewed, the interviewers, if it's a panel interview or if there are many of them who will do the interview, they're staying in a separate room and they're making some observations while they are waiting for your turn to be interviewed. So that moment, they're already starting making an assessment, an evaluation of the applicant. If your nonverbal communication skills aren't up to par, it won't matter how well you answer the question. So even if your answer is so substantial, your eloquence, your spontaneous and the like, but your nonverbal communication speaks otherwise, you know, you have to take note of that, no? Again, you will not get the job, all right? So you have to be careful. Things that you need to observe, especially in the nonverbal communication. Nonverbal communication is driven by someone's emotional state and instinct. So why we value the physical, the nonverbal communication of an applicant? Because it speaks about your emotional state, your feeling and your instinct. So how you're feeling, like nervousness and not very confident, you'll be more likely to fidget and avoid eye contact. So even the tone of your voice, even your gesture, even the movement, the facial expressions that you have will speak something about how do you feel. No, if you're not confident, if you are not, if you're nervous, all right? So you have to practice yourself, all All right. You have to practice that you will sound confident, that you sound okay, that you sound relaxed. Because no one would like to listen to someone who is nervous, diba? Okay. For sure, you don't like to listen to someone who sounds nervous, who sounds not confident, who sounds not ready, diba? So, and this is one thing that you can prepare for yourself. No, you can practice this. All right. Okay. The interviewer's reaction to job candidates are strongly influenced by the applicant's appearance. So this one came out in the Mentimeter. And, you know, even if you just came in a room, no, or if you're in a virtual interview, the moment that pumasok ka, makita ka sa video or what, your appearance, how you look the time, no, the moment that you're there, will say something about, you know, the impression of the interviewer, no? So kung medyo you don't look ready, all right, in terms of your physical appearance, in terms of your attire, in terms of the way that you carry yourself, then the impression is that you are not ready for the job. You know what I mean? Okay. Studies show that persons who are attractive and appropriately dressed generally receive higher ratings than ones judged to be unattractive or inappropriately dressed. So, it's about, as I said, pwede mo naman siya mapaghandaan, no? Unang-una, yung suot mo, kung ano ang suot mo, yung iyong gestures, yung facial expressions, no? Pwede mo siya mapaghandaan, all right? And dahil pwede siya mapaghandaan, and if you look different, no? If you are not that person who come to an interview who is not ready and who is not prepared, then, di ba? I mean, you know, common sense will tell us that why the interviewer will consider you for the position after all, right? Okay. An interviewee must be credible. In order for him or for her to form a positive impression, they must have self-confidence, attitude, and positive personality traits. So, As I mentioned in our first session, my first session with you, the questions in the job interview are the same over and over again. No? And why is it that, you know, we are nervous? We feel nervous during the interview because there might be some thinking, no, that we cannot answer to questions. And why we cannot answer to questions after all? The questions are all about our competence, our ability, about who we are, all right? Okay. So that's why we are here. That's why the last part of our session today is mock interview because, as I said, the more that you participate in a session like this, the more that you submit yourself to a dreaded situation like this, the more that you can gain confidence, all right? So it's about sharpening your saw, okay? Human communication consists of 65% nonverbal communication. Only 35% consists of words. No, so you see, for example, if you're in a date, you're celebrating your week's salary with your hubby or your squeezy in a candlelit dinner, diba? And naade ka sa Rojas kay candlelit dinner man ka na mga suga-suga, no? Nag-date ka, nag-celebrate mo sa inyong week's salary. If you're on a date tapos napansin mo na yung ka-date mo, the full attention is not in you kasi nag-text siya, no? Nagakuri-kuri siya sa iyong cellphone or nagatanaw siya sa lain, di ba? Di ba malain ka, no? You will not be happy about it. Ako, I don't like that, no? Kung ako ang imuhang kasabay tapos ingon na imong buhaton, mabiyaan yun ta ka, di ba? Because your full attention is not with me. Even if you're talking to me, but the fact that I notice that your nonverbal communication speaks otherwise, therefore, you are not interested in what we are doing in our session, diba? Okay. So that's how important human nonverbal communication in a human communication is. And what are those nonverbal communication? These are facial expressions, diba? Do not frown, no? Mug-utik beauty ka ba, di ba? I mean, you don't like to be with person who na mug-utik beauty, di ba? Kanang nag-radiate ng negative energy. Negative lang siya siguro sa COVID test. Okay, ganahan taan na. Pero kung negative ang iyang energy na gina-radiate sa ato, we don't like to be with that person, right? Okay. The tone of your voice, I've been telling you that you can practice, no? You can record your voice, listen to your voice, and feel like, you know, if there's something about your voice, you like it, you don't like it, you adjust. You can do that, no? Movements, your movements. In fact, ako, and in, this is also in connection with gestures, no? In fact, even if I'm just talking to my laptop now, but I have to feel that, you know, you're there, no? You're watching me, you're in front of me, and that, you know, I also have to give some gestures for me to emphasize some things, and it will bolster my emphasis, no? If I'm emphasizing things, it will bolster, it will give a clearer picture of the message that I'm trying to relate to you, all right? Okay. Your appearance, all right? How you look, diba? Kung medyo pananaw na to nga wakay ligo, you're not ready for that interview, for that occasion, diba? I mean, what impression and what message you're trying to deliver, no? To show to the interviewer, all right? So you have to prepare for that, and it will form part of our discussion this afternoon. And your eye contact, no? And if you're, for example, in a remote virtual interview, just like what we're doing right now, the thing is that you have to have your eye contact to the camera, no, of your laptop, of your computer, because it will direct also to the eyes of, you know, the one who's there in the computer, who's watching you, no, via the Zoom or via the computer, all right? Okay. And then verbal is 35%. So what are the advisable body language during job interview? If you're in a face-to-face interview, have a firm handshake. If your handshake is too slack, it will seem as if you're not interested. You make eye contact with the interviewer for a few seconds at a time. You smile and you nod at appropriate times when the interviewer is talking. Do not laugh unless the interviewer does first, no? Okay? All right. Don't slouch. I said you have to sit up straight, no? You have to look confident. Do relax and lean forward a little towards the interviewer so you appear interested and engaged. Don't lean back, no? So like for example, even if you're in a remote virtual interview like this, and if you lean your back at the back of the chair, just like what I'm doing right now, then it will be seen by the interviewer and that you will look too casual and relaxed. It's not an advisable thing because, as I said, that the interviewer holds a higher position, and it's not a good nonverbal communication to show some respect to the person who's doing the interview. You keep your feet on the floor and your back against the lower back of the chair. You pay attention and be interested. You listen, do not interrupt, you stay calm, even if you had a bad experience in previous job interviews. You keep your emotions to yourself, okay? Not sure what to do with your hands, especially if you're in a face-to-face interview, you hold a pen and notepad or rest an arm on the chair or on your lap so you look comfortable. Ako, I have been doing that, you know, it's my penchant. If I'm in a situation like that, if I'm in an interview, if I'm in a dreaded moment like job interview, I really have to bring pen. I remember when I was like interview in an embassy for my visa application, I was so tense that time, so tense. Why? Because prior to my interview, I heard that those who came over for an interview, no, before I came over, they were denied of their visa application. So I was like, you know, why they were denied, no? Despite the fact that we were accepted for a scholarship for a travel grant in the US, why they were denied? So I also have a feeling that there is also a possibility that I will be denied. So that makes me so tense. So ako, you know, every time if I'm in that situation, there are two things, no? One is that, yeah, I bring a pen because I believe that pen is a source of knowledge. And so if I need to like share something, speak something, no, speak prolific ideas and the like, then I have to bring pen because I feel like pen can help me draw out prolific ideas, you know, good ideas. So feeling ko, pag naghahawak ako ng pen, I can like talk a lot. I can like share a lot. I can like, I will not be stammered, no. Second is that I'm going to wear my favorite clothes. I have clothes intended for that occasion because the moment that I'm going to wear that, it can bolster my confidence. No? It can like, you know, feel me that I can feel like I'm good. I'm in good attire. And this attire really can give a good impression that, hey, you have to accord me some level of respect. You know what I mean? Okay. Don't let your arms fly around the room when you're making a point. So let's talk about attire. And we said that your personal appearance can make a first impression about you. No? So even if you have not started talking yet, but sometimes your attire during job interview can influence the behavior, the attitude of the interviewer. And eventually it can also influence the way that the interviewer will ask questions to you based on your attire. No? So let's talk about attire first, no? And let's start with the guys, with the gentlemen. Well, you can work with colors and layers. Ka-ed 500 students, there is an impression that your generation is iGen, no? And that your generation, you have tastes for fashion and style, no? Kayo yung may mga fashion and style kasi nga nauso sa inyo ang OOTD, eh, di ba? Oh, so, ibig sabihin, magaling kayo mag-critique, magaling kayo mag-appreciate ng mga color coordinations and the like, all right? And so you have to show that during job interview, because if you're like that, if you can do that during interview, it will give an impression that there's this person has taste for art, for style, and is a creative-minded person, diba? So pag creative ang tao, for sure, gusto mo talaga yun siya kasi creative siya, magaling siya mag-isip, magaling siya mag-mix and match ng mga colors, diba? So, alam mo yun, diba? Madiskarte ang tao na to, no? Okay? All right, so, and you are also showing that you are really an iGen, no? Diba? So, mani, kung dili ka ingon anak mang good, diba? I mean, asa ka ba na generation na belong? You're not part of our generation. You're from the different dream. You're from a different generation. So you really have to show your generation, all right? Sweater and button down, if the interview happens during rainy season, during cold season, like our season now, no? It has been raining every night. So, yeah, you can wear sweater and button down. Or if the job requires you to move a lot, if there's a lot of mobility happening from one place to another, you need to travel, no? The job requires someone to travel a lot, then you can wear sweater and button down. Because in that sense, you are trying to show a message that I know the requirement of the position and I'm always on the go, all right? Okay. Navy blue blazer. So opposite naman doon sa sweater button down, itong navy blue blazer, if the position, if the job requires you most of the time to stay in the office and face the top honchos, no? Mga who's who in the organization, in your office, mga middle managers, higher managers, and the like, then you have to be corporatist in your look, no? The word there is corporatist. You have to be corporatist in your look, then you can wear navy blue blazer because at least corporate ang arrive mo. But again, bakit blue ang nasulat ko? Dahil ang blue kasi, meron kasi impression sa inyong generation that you are not loyal. Kaya nga nauso sa inyo ang kasabihang hashtag walang forever. Kasi kayo yung mga taong, mga henerasyon na madali kayo magsawa, no? Ang dali ninyo magsawa, ayaw nyo na sa ganito, ayaw nyo na sa ganyan, nanggo-ghosting na kayo kasi, di ba, kahit scene, hindi na nyo na ginagawa, di ba? Kasi nagsasawa na kayo, madali kayo magsawa. So, by wearing blue, you're trying to show an image otherwise, a different image that you're not, you're loyal, di ba? So, there's a possibility that if you will be hired in the company, and that you will be the company will treat you well, then you're going to stay in the company for so long or in the organization for so long. Okay? And what I like also about blue is that you can match that with different colors of the pants. So in that sense, yun, no? Pwede natin masabi uli na may fashion and may ano ka, taste for fashion and style. Okay? Casual button down, this one you will never go wrong. Okay? If you do not know what's the requirement of the position and if you want to be to have a good mix of mobility and corporatist look than try to have a casual button down or black and white. I mean, this one is an old one, an old style, an old fashion, but you know, this is timeless. Okay. All right. So for the guys, you can bring suit para at least corporate ang dating mo, no? Solid color, then match that with a long sleeve. Pag nakasuit ka, dapat long sleeve, ha? Hindi short sleeve, no? Di pwede yun. Belts and then tie, dark socks, conservative leather shoes, little or no jewelry. I'd like to ask the guys, what's the most important accessory for the guys, for the gentlemen? Ano ba? Type your answer in the chat box. The answer is watch, no? Okay, watch. So, and in fact, makita mo yung status ng tao, ang kanyang personality, sa kanyang relo na sinusuot. That's why, aside from you invest in a nice attire for your interview and for your work someday, you also invest in a nice watch. Okay? Because as I said, watch can tell about personality, about one's personality and about one's perception in life, about your perspective in life and about your social status in life. Okay? Neat professional hairstyle. Limit the aftershave. Neatly trimmed nails. And I'm sure the ladies will agree with me if I would say that guys with untrimmed nails are so yucks. No? I mean, pag makakita ko lalaki nga ka ng mga dagko kay mga kuko, tagas ang kuko, feeling na ko mga bitukon na sila. No? Kasi pagtaas kasi na kuko, nangasuksok din to ang mga yuta, tapos kito ni mo, eyo. Diba? So, not good. you can bring portfolio or briefcase. I mean, do not bring backpack in a job interview. All right? There's a proper time and proper occasion for you to bring your backpack. No? But bringing portfolio or briefcase is, you know, will bolster the positive impression. Just like this morning, I have interviewed one Kain 500 student. No, she volunteered for the mock interview and she's working. No, she had several jobs and she said that. So I was like impressed, no? She worked, she hopped from one company to another. And so I said, wow, that's nice. I mean, you have a nice work experience. How did you able to do that, no? She were able to get this information through LinkedIn. And I think I mentioned about LinkedIn last session that it would be nice for you Kain 500 students to have a LinkedIn profile, because if you include that in your resume that you have a LinkedIn profile, it will bolster your chances. You know, hiring officers are much more likely to hire an applicant with a LinkedIn profile rather than you are only having your Facebook or your Instagram as your profile, no? Social media profile. So create your LinkedIn profile. So same thing about portfolio or briefcase. If you're an applicant that you bring backpack in a job interview, I mean, X, diba? If I'm an interviewer, X, agad, diba? Okay, all right. Because it's about perception, it's about maturity, it's about professionalism. You know what I mean? It's about responsibility, diba? For the ladies, these are the suggested interview attire. One is sweater and black dress pants, or experimenting with button down. These first two, if you know, you will look comfortable. If you're going to travel back from your house, going to the place of the interview, especially if you're going to take some cabs or some jeeps or what, no? So this one makes you comfortable. And if especially just like the guys, if the job requires you to travel a lot, then this one is more appropriate. Again, if the job requires you to face the boss most of the time, if you're going to stay in the office also most of the time, then you can wear navy blue blazer and khaki shirt for you to be corporatist in look. And again, blue because of the impression of loyalty, no? Right? button down and V-neck sweater if the job requires you to move a lot, to travel a lot. There's a lot of travel, no? Hopping from one place to another. So you're expressing a message that you're a person who is always on the go. If the job actually is in marketing, or if you're like the position requires you to deal with some potential clients, then you have to be ladylike. You have to show your soft touch, the soft side in you. Then you can wear statement dresses, no? Okay. Print cardigans or black dress and ties. This one, if the job requires highly technical knowledge, no, like engineering, architecture, yeah, because if color blue represents loyalty, color black represents authority, no? So when you say authority, which means that you are knowledgeable, you are skillful, you know the requirement of the position, especially if you are going to use some equipment or some machines, no? Okay. Ayan. Let's talk about entrepreneurship before we proceed to mock interview, because we understand that some of you don't like to be an employee for so long for the rest of your career. Some of you probably have in mind to pursue your own business, start your own business, and be your own boss, no? So let's talk about a bit entrepreneurship. So it says here that entrepreneurship is working for oneself. For those of you who don't like to have a boss, no? You don't like to get an order, receive an order from someone else, then you run your own business, start your own business. You can do that, especially if you have your capital. So let's take a look at what are the qualities of an entrepreneur and find out if you have this, no? If you know all of these qualities are present in you, then there's a possibility that you will be a successful entrepreneur. First up is that you're a risk taker, no? You're a person who are not afraid of taking risks, especially in your age right now. You're young, you have nothing to lose. If you fail, no, if you commit mistake, then learn from that and see a mistake as something that will make you a better person, something that will help you grow. But I warn you that do not commit the same mistake over and over. You know, if you commit that mistake at the first time, okay, learn from that. But if you commit at the second time, ay halakatanga ka na, no? Diba? Mali ka na, no? Talaga. So there is something wrong in you. You do it again for the third time, ay wa na, pakiparok na lang sa imong ulo sa simento. Okay? That's the best thing that you can do. Alright? So, as said, do not be afraid to fail, experience failure, commit a mistake, but learn from that. You're willing to work hard, no? You're not that person who counts the hours of you working, because there are other people that, you know, they want to report to office at 8 o'clock and leave at 5 because 8 hours lang talaga ako mag-work. Ganyan, no? Enough na yan, no? So hindi ka pwede. You don't have that quality of an entrepreneur, of willing to work hard, passionate about pursuing a business idea. And when you say entrepreneur or business idea, you have creative mind, no? You want to pursue a business that is not there yet, all right? It's something new, okay? Di po na pwede ka mo yung kag-entrepreneur ka niya. Mura di ang pagiging negosyante, sari-sari store, na malita ka sa SM, na malita ka sa mall niya, mura gibaligya, di ba? I mean, you know, what is new about that, di ba? So the thing there is that there must be something. You have introduced something new, a new product or a new idea, a new service in the market, okay? You're not afraid to lose money, time, and face because you're a risk taker, all right? Pero hindi po pwede na perminti ka na lang na lose, okay? Learn from your mistake. You can easily bounce back when things fail. So ikaw yung taong madali makabangon, no? Dali makamove on, madali makarecover, okay? You're physically and emotionally able to withstand the pressures. You are resourceful and innovative. You can envision the future. You know how to sell and market your products and service, and you can handle money well. So ikaw, i-test mo, no? Prudent ka ba in your fiscal management, no? In your personal finance, all right? Prudent ka ba, no? or ikaw yung tao na splurge masyado. Okay, so tingnan mo kung may 1,000 ka, how long your 1,000 pesos will last in your coffer, in your pocket. Okay,
okay.
So what does it take to become an entrepreneur? You assess yourself, you take a look at the qualities that I have presented. If you have all those qualities, then maybe, you know, you ask advice and ask for help. You start investing in social capital. Alam mo yon? You stop rubbing elbow with people whom you think you can help you in the future. Check in your bucket list of friends, no? Baka kasi ang mga friends mo ngayon, yung mga kapareho mo lang, no? Kung 21 years old ka, mga estudyante din sila. Wala kang kakilala, wala kang friends na who are more mature, who are successful, who have occupied higher positions. I mean, 'di ba? Invest, kaya nga sinasabi natin, invest in social capital. Because these people can help you someday. Eh yung mga kapareho mo, mga classmates mo, kalidad mo, they cannot. Pwede lang na nimo maaduan, mahilak-hilak ka, may problema ka, pero can they like help you push your career higher to a higher level, di ba? So look for people whom you think that, you know, someday they can help you, all right? They are more mature, they are more successful, and that when you listen to them, you can learn from them, okay? And the nice thing is, if you want to pursue entrepreneurship also, you know, there are opportunities for financing. No? There are government institutions that may provide assistance for those who want to start their own business. You just submit requirements. You just go through some processes. Of course, it's not a silver platter that will be served you as easily as that. No, so you have to go through some processes. No, and if they found out that you deserve to be granted assistance, financial assistance, then you can do that. No? Minsan, diskarte mo lang talaga yan, no? Maghanap ng mga capital, no? Mga financial resources and the like. Okay? So, we can now proceed to our workshop in our job interview, no? Our mock interview. Just remember that in interview, there's the rule of three. You have to be brief. You have to be articulate and structured. Alam nyo bakit hindi natitense kayo? Because ang isang rason niyan is that hindi nyo alam paano i-structure ang question ninyo, ang sagot ninyo, no? Paano ninyo siya, ano ba dapat ang mauna? Paano nyo ba i-attack yung question? Alright? So practice yourself having your own structure. Alright? Rule of marketing. Why marketing? Because you're the one selling yourself, no? So how you do that? You address their needs, no? The needs of the interviewer, the needs of the organization. And if they're going to hire you, then what's in it for them? You focus on them. They're the most important entity. You're not, I mean, I'm not saying that you're not important, but the most important in terms of ranking between you and the entity, between you and the interviewer, they're the most important. Especially if you want the job badly, then you really have to show that, you know, you will contribute something to the furtherance of the organization if they're going to hire you, if they're going to consider you for the position. So again, why be nervous? Because of uncertainties. You are not sure of what to be asked and how to answer the questions. And after all, the questions are all about your life, about the job, and about the organization. Okay? If there are questions that are not relevant, if you think that are not relevant, sometimes it's just there for ice-breaking purposes. You not necessarily have to provide a cogent and rational and prolific answers. You know what I mean? But at least you can respond to that question. Later on, there are questions that are not relevant, and let's see how are you going to manage that situation. So are you going to prepare yourself? You remind yourself that you're in a job interview. You research the company. And then look at your skills, match your skills with the requirement of the position, with the expectations of the company, and then your potential. All right? Okay. So this time, I'm going to turn over the activity, the mock interview activity, to Benji. No? Benji. Sige. Ang question, anak Benji, na ba kay question ako?
I sige lang, sir, I'll just control your kuan. Allow me to control your PowerPoint.
Can you do that?
Yes.
Wow, it's my first time to hear that, ha? Oh, ganyan ba? Yung ka mag-ganyan, alam mo yon? May knowledge ka ba? May techie ka? Alam, di ba? So I'm surprised. It's my first time to know that. So I have to approve it.
Yes, sir. Alala.
Approve. Oh, okay.
Ayan. So now I can control.
Hala, sabi niya, deny daw. Zoom,
deny to
control this computer using accessibility feature. Can you control now? Can you or you cannot?
Dili ata, sir.
Palpas. Siya ko na lihatag ako ang lafi sa imuha.
Sige, sir.
Different
unit.
Ha?
Basig
different ang unit.
Ay, up nun eh.
Di, pato
ko
niya sa system's preference. Strict to ka, sir. Strict to yung mga laptop. So, sino ang mag-volunteer? Just raise your hand or comment your name at the chat box.
Hello? Okay, no one will volunteer? Okay, so I'll be the one to choose. So I will mention your name, so please turn on your mic and also turn on your camera so that we can start our interview. Okay, so as I've mentioned no, kanina sa ano ni sir, so we'll have our mock interview. So you assume that you're already a graduate and then you're applying for the entry level position, okay? But before that, you introduce yourself, your name, your course, okay? And later I'll give some also kanang mga preparatory questions.
So, sino mag-volunteer?
Check.
Kung sino man yung pinakamaganda magsagot this day, this afternoon, magbibigay kami ng prize.
Hello, wala ka doon ka. Okay, let's have first Emmanuel Ibasco. Emmanuel, please turn on your mic and also turn on your camera. Emmanuel? Okay, sir Ray. Ibasco, Emmanuel. Asa mo si Emmanuel? Naman to ka ganina.
Okay.
Ay, unmute mo muna, sir Emmanuel. Pwede ka
maka-unmute, Emmanuel. Pwede mo na ma-unmute, Emmanuel.
Di daw ma-unmute, sir. Not allowing daw. Try to unmute daw karon.
Yapon, Emmanuel.
Ayan.
Yes, sir. Hello.
Yes, hello. I can hear your voice now.
Hi, sir.
There you go.
Hello pala account mo, kaya saan na ang gina-unmute ko yung may picture?
I sorry, sir.
Okay, so please tell us about yourself, Emmanuel.
Yes, sir. Good afternoon. My name is Emmanuel Nazari Basco. I am a third-year social work student under the BS Social Work Department.
Oh, parang kailan lang, man. You were just senior high school. Right now,
yes,
you are third-year college. So parang tumatanda na ako nito. Well, anyways, okay, so social work. Okay, what brought you to take up social work?
The center or the core reason why I took the social work course is because of my passion to serve others. I believe in the quote, passion to serve, compassion for others, where people's lives should be used to help and serve other people. And I think that's the main purpose of our existence here in the earth.
Wow, that's great. That's a good thinking, no, in terms of being passionate to what you love. All right, so assume, no, that you're already a graduate and you are applying for the position of being a social worker. Okay, are you ready?
Yes, sir.
All right, let's begin. Here's your first question, Eman. Okay, what can you do for us that other candidates can't?
I believe, sir, that my when it comes to my skills, I believe that my technical skills that I have acquired from working with various companies will be an advantage for me that I can contribute for your company. I believe that I can learn quickly and I can absorb different skills within a matter of days, depending on the technicality, sir. But in terms of technical aspects, especially when it comes to tech-savvy task, I believe, sir, that I can definitely do my best in any kinds of field in that particular skill.
All right. Okay, how has your experience in your college prepared you for your career?
Actually, sir, this question, I've had a lot of experiences in my college years, and most of them came from the academic, but more came from outside during my years as a college student. I have learned how to manage both my work and my academics for the past 4 years. And I think that's what really matters when you're in the university. It doesn't, yes, surely that the academics and the grades matter, but what matters most is how you manage your time, how you solve problems. And I believe that problem solving skills is the best way that, or the best thing that I have learned as I have progressed and finished my college career.
All right. Okay. So if I were to ask your professor, or were you able to have an experience of working in a certain company?
Related to my major, sir, not related.
Were you able to have a work while you're having your studies?
Yes, sir. I've been working with 3 companies during my college years. I've worked in an ESL company. I've worked as a teacher for Asian nationalities for 3 years. Mm-hmm. And I've also worked as a virtual assistant for real estate companies and travel agencies.
So in that manner, so what would you think that they can describe you? What would they say about you?
I think, sir, if you would be asking them that question, well, my wild guess would be versatility. I believe that I can adjust to different situations that has been placed in front of me. And I think that's what they would firstly say when being asked with that question, sir.
Can you elaborate the word versatility in the things that you've done in your previous work? Even in your college days, can you cite an example?
Yes, sir. When I was in second year, I was placed into a very difficult situation where I was assigned a task that I was not really good at. However, sir, because of my motivation to conquer and to achieve a satisfiable outcome, I was able to execute it properly. And I think that was one of the achievements that I consider very important for me as I was inside the college as a college student. So not only that, but as well as I like to try different kinds of fields and different skills, because for me, skills are a great investment as a person. And I believe that when you have a specific skill set, that would really make you very versatile when it comes to different kinds of situations. So you can adjust and cope to different kinds of problems.
All right. So what salary are you expecting, man?
When it comes to the salary, sir, I believe that this company is very competitive. I know that you have been renowned for giving high compensations to your employees. So I'm not expecting any specific amount, but I think we can negotiate on this matter afterwards, sir.
All right. Thank you so much, Eman, no, for being the first, no, to be interviewed in this mock interview.
Thank you very much, sir.
All right.
Thank you, Emmanuel. So next is Nasra. Can you open your mic, please?
Okay, so that's from the College of Arts and Sciences Education. La, you set the bar, Eman. So let's see the next.
So this bar, the next is Miss Nasra Rilino. So from the College of Criminal Justice Education.
All right.
So, okay, Nasra, you can unmute yourself now.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Hi, Nasra. Can you introduce yourself?
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Nasra Rialino, a fourth-year Bachelor of Science and Criminology student.
All right. How are you, Nasra?
I am fine, sir.
Parang familiar ka din sa akin.
You have been my teacher in senior high, sir.
Yeah, I know. Okay, so let's start na our interview. So assume na that you are already na a graduate na, and then you are applying for an intro level. Okay? Sige. Okay, let's start. Before, no? What brought you to take up Bachelor of Science in Criminology?
Ever since I was a kid, sir, it has been my dream to become a part of the police force, to serve the public and offer my life in service of the public.
Wow.
And this course has given me a chance to serve the public more and offer my life for them.
All right. Okay. Let's start. So speaking of life, okay, offering life, if you had to live your life over again, what one thing you would change?
If given the chance, sir, I would not change a thing in my life now, because the experiences that have I experience are giving me lessons that I can bring and pass on to my children when the time comes.
Oh, Miss Universe. Anyways, let's have another question. So, is there anything else I should know about you, Nasra?
The thing that you should know about me, sir, is that I am frank. When I see something that I am not comfortable with or I don't agree with, I will talk to the person who is in charge of the thing that I am not comfortable with to negotiate about that thing, so we can talk about that in a good way or in a manner that the both parties can understand the problem and we can work on a solution to solve that problem.
All right. So if you are an animal, which one would you want to be?
If I become an animal, I would be an eagle. An eagle, because the eagle sees everything in a plain view. So I want to be someone who sees everything in a fair and a level view. Because if I become a law enforcer, I should see both parties equal. I should listen to both sides or look at the two sides of the coin, and I should look at them equally.
Right. So how would you rate yourself from 1 to 10?
I would rate myself as 9, because if I rate myself 10, there would be no chance for improvement. I rate myself as 9, so I have a room to improve myself, to be better and not be best.
Okay, so I think this is very parang aligned to your job. So will you relocate does relocation bother you?
If given a chance, sir, where service calls me, I am willing to relocate. This is my sworn profession. This is my sworn job. So if the task or the job asks me to relocate, I will relocate. And relocation does not bother me at all because this is an opportunity to meet new people, to learn about the culture, to learn about the people that I will work with.
All right. So thank you very much, Nasra.
Okay. Thank you, Nasra. Very well said. So next is Lars for that.
Okay. Grabe, no?
Very competitive.
Very sila. Competitive.
Parang pang Miss Universe yung mga sagot nila. Okay. Next is Lars. Good afternoon, yes. Lars.
Good afternoon, sir.
Okay. Take the floor, Sir Benji.
Okay, Lars, kindly introduce yourself.
Yes, sir. Hello there. Good afternoon to everyone. My name is Lars Howard Forden, and I am 25 years old, living here in Davao City, and I am a third-year college, taking up a Bachelor of Science in Secondary Education, majored in English.
Oh, so your education.
Yes, sir.
So you're part of the organization Elites. Okay, so why education?
Well, sir, education is one of my passion. Teaching kids is also one of my passion. When I was a child, my mom was actually a religious teacher. So she teaches Sabbath school. So she teaches things that related to Bible. And I was one of the volunteer teachers when I was young. And of course, it got me that I want to teach children so for them to learn and to give the knowledge that I've learned as well during my journey, and of course sharing also the information that I have or that I have experienced.
So why English, not science or Filipino or social studies? Why English?
Well, for me, English is a very unique, fancy, elegant, and of course when you speak in English, it's more on not just like the language but more on technicalities like grammars and other kinds of things that you have to learn about English, like the words, the pronunciation, how you're able to pronounce the words correctly. And of course, English is, for me, it's more on poetic. So when I speak in English, it's a very like a music to my ear. And when I create a poems using English language, it makes me feel more relaxed. And of course, for me, it is a very unique kind of language.
All right. So thank you so much for that. Let's start our interview. Assume that you're already a graduate. Okay. And then you're applying for an entry level. And I want you to answer this question also being answered a while ago by Nasra. So will you relocate? Does relocation bother you?
Well, for me, relocation is not a big problem for me because as a teacher, I have this kind of duty to serve the people, especially to the kids. So whenever they need me, I will really go.
So even if you will just cross how many rivers?
Yes, sir.
That's that would fine be for okay me. For you. All right. Okay. How many hours a week do you usually work and why?
Well, currently now I am also working as a part-time tutor in an ESL company. So I've been working for like 8 hours every day. Mm-hmm. And of course for me, it's fine because it is required work hours for me to work. And if the working schedule is, let's say, for example, 6 hours to 8 hours, I would gladly accept it because that is a required time for this kind of job. So I'd willingly accept it. And of course, if it is required for me to work in those kinds of hours, then I would do my best to give my best and, of course, to support the job that I'm trying to apply.
What if it requires more than 8 hours? So especially that you're a teacher, no, it doesn't only need an 8 hour a day. Would you like to have that one also?
Well, it depends, sir, because based on the law, teacher should work from 6 hours to 8 hours. But if I work more than 8 hours, so there would be like an additional payment for that.
So you know you want additional payment?
Yes, sir, because all it's right. Abide by the law.
Okay. So tell me about the last time you had a disagreement with someone. Are you in a relationship right now?
No, sir. I'm completely single.
All right. So can you answer the question? Tell me about the last time you had a disagreement with someone.
When it comes to disagreement, I'm kind of person who actually listen to both sides. So whenever, when it comes to my problem, so if I evaluate it, it's my problem. So I try to find a way for me to meet with a with my other or with a person and having an argument with. So when it comes to disagreement, I don't have a lot of experiences because I'm trying to be rational. And I'm trying to think over and over before I react. So I don't have those kinds of any experience yet.
You're like, okay, sige. So this one, if I gave you an elephant, where would you hide it?
So if you gave me an elephant, so maybe, to be honest, I can't really hide an elephant because it's really big. So instead of hiding it, maybe I'm just going to show it that this is my elephant. And of course, I'm proud of it. And I'm willing to share it with other kids.
All right. So hiding is not your mantra.
Yeah.
So what has been your most disappointing experience? More of the questions given to you, parang disagreement, disappointing.
Yes.
Okay.
Well, actually, the most disappointing experience that I had is during my time before the lockdown. So mm-hmm. It was way before 2 years ago. So I was actually fired by one of the companies. It's because of the internet problem. So I cannot actually provide it directly because of all those services that are not yet available during those times. I did try my best to find another way to solve that kind of problem, but unfortunately, because of the current situation, so it's just, for me, I just need to accept the consequences and try for a new angle, look for a new angle.
All right. Thank you so much, Lars.
You're welcome, sir.
Thank you, Lars.
From CASE to CCJE to CTE, anong next?
Magpapatalo ba mga taga CBAE dito, Human Resource Management? Ito yung field nyo. Saan na kayo?
I would like to volunteer Giovanni Garcia. CBAE yan.
Okay, Giovanni. Can you turn on your camera, please?
Ayan, there's Giovanni.
My God, Sir Bench.
Alright, please tell me about yourself, Giovanni.
So, hi everyone. I am Giovanni Garcia. I am currently on my fourth year as a BA, a BSBA Marketing Management major student. And yeah, that's it for now.
Why marketing, not financial? Or other major of BSBA?
Not to discriminate other courses, but I do believe marketing management is the most creative business management course since it deals with how to market a product or to determine different kinds of problems in the society and to provide a solution to the problem.
Oh, okay, so let's start our interview. So assume that you're already a graduate of the marketing management major of business Bachelor of Science in Business Administration. So can you answer the first question? What has been your most disappointing experience?
I do believe my most disappointing experience is my coming out to my family later than what I expected. For everyone's information, I am gay and I've been out for my family since last year and I regret doing that later in my life. So my family already know that I am gay and they are so proud of me. And I regret doing it later. Maybe if I did it earlier in my lifetime, I would be more comfortable and more open to them.
In that way, you will become, you're like free now, no? For
Yeah, like okay. a free bird.
Yeah,
not
flying
a bird in
the sky.
Yes.
Okay. So this one, I've seen applicants with good impressive credentials and good years of experience. So why should hire you for the job and not them?
Yes, I can gauge my skills and abilities to other people since I don't have their credentials. But kidding aside, my years of experience in college, my seminars, and I was also able to experience an exchange student program. And I do believe those credentials and seminars that I've attended to is my tool to be competitive and to be most fit in this position.
So what college subjects, speaking of those experiences that you had in college, what college subjects did you like least and why?
I do believe that I have having hard time on the subject sales management because aside from it is really hard as the nature of the subject, I do believe that getting information from the companies in terms of their sales is very difficult at this time since companies are very strict in terms of publicating their sales records, and that what makes us having hard time to deal with their sales records.
So this is a situation. You're in a boat on a freshwater in Lake Lanao. In your hand is a rock. You throw the rock into the lake. How is the lake's water level affected?
I do believe it's a hard question, but the water will still be the same. It should still be water. It's since I am my hands are the rock, the buoyancy will bring my weight to the bottom. And the question is, how would it affect the water? As I think that the water level will still be the same.
Okay, what is the important lesson you have learned from this pandemic? And how this has changed your perspective? So this is very Miss Universe question.
Mm-hmm. Since the pandemic started last year, and I was out to my family also last year. So the greatest lesson is to be more open and more honest to your family because there are no other people that will believe in you, support you, except from your family. And aside from that, during this pandemic, I was also able to play more games such as Mobile Legend. And the funny thing is that I've learned different things in Mobile Legend. Even though you fail once, you have also the opportunity to plan and to strive again in order to achieve victory.
All right. Thank you so much, Giovanni.
Thank you, sir.
All right.
Oh, good up. Thank you, Giovanni. So next is Harry. So Harry, can you turn on your camera, please?
My God. Okay. Hello. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Harry.
Yes, I think all of the students are good in terms of this, but I'll try my best.
All right. Okay. What code are you, Harry?
I forgot. I think I'm sir.
It's under me, I guess, sir.
And yes. Sir Freyland. Sir Marvin. All right. So Harry, can you tell us more about yourself?
Yes, Harry Venge Farolan, 26, 4-year student in BSBA, major in human resource management.
Okay. Mm-mm. Why human resource?
I'm actually like in an industry which is in BPO. I like work with people. One of the perks of being HR is getting to know every single person in the company. So like I love like recruit on how recruitment works, getting people to get an applicant suits on that job. That's it.
All right. Okay. So let's start now our interview. So assume that you are applying for an entry level. Sure. Would that be okay for you, entry level?
Yes. I'll try my best. My God.
To be an entry level. All right. Sige. Let's start with the question being flashed right now. So what is the important lesson you have learned from this pandemic and how this has changed your perspective?
I think make sure that you have savings. In March 2020, I only have 20 pesos in my pocket. And at that time, I was like on floating, or should I say like I don't have job, it's jobless. So for me, the lesson there is make sure you have like savings in the future. And you have actually savings in the future so that if that, you know, pandemic happened again, you don't need to worry about it.
Mm-hmm. So savings is very important.
Yes, exactly.
So that's why part no of our like in career portfolio yung tinatawag natin na professional goals, and then yung financial stability, no, financial goals, kailangan yan. All right. Yes. So where do you see yourself in 7 years?
Where do I see myself in 7 years? Of course, as a human resource manager. Why? That's actually my dream since I have my first job. Being in that position, it's not that easy. And it's like very challenging because from the time that the company started, what you're doing as a man, as a human resource manager, is to get the best, you know, best applicant or best employee to make sure that your company will work well or going smoothly. Yes.
So when was the last time you broke the rules? What was the situation and what did you do?
Okay. As my experience, I actually a lot, I think seven, you know, companies, or I, this is my 9 companies, actually, my presence, my 9 companies, BPO. The last time that I broke the rules is like doing that my job well. Because at the very beginning, yes, I'm actually like a customer service. I'm a top agent. And at the end of the day, I mean, and the long run, I actually realized that why I should my give at all, you know, like, sorry. I'm actually nervous, guys, because
just relax.
the question itself is like, you know, a Miss Universe. But of course, okay, going back. Sorry for that, for, you know, the interruptions or advertisements. Of course, broke the rules. First, I actually broke the rules. Of course, there's a lot. First, absenteeism, like doing fraud. I actually did that. But really? Of course, for me to, yes, not totally fraud, I actually doing that to make sure that my score will actually went up. Because I actually need to have the job and to have this incentives to make sure that I can still send myself in, you know, in the University of Mindanao. But I realized at the end of the day, what was the situations and what did you do? What I did, I actually have a confrontations with my HR, one of my HR manager, and I actually informed him about what's happened, and I resigned. Because, you know, remember that integrity, honesty, integrity is very important to each you know, company. So that's the best thing that I've did in that company.
All right. Yes. So what can you say?
Oh, go ahead.
So what can you say about those who are non-vaxxers?
For that, regarding to this one, I'm not, because non-vaxxers, for me, I think all of us should be have this. Yes. Because I'm actually one of the positive COVID-19, which has happened last December. And I think best thing for us to do is needs to have these vaccinations, because this has actually helped a lot, not only with our, you know, with our health, but of course in our community.
All right. Thank you so much, Harry Bench Farola.
Yes, thank you so much.
All right.
So thank you, Harry. So
I think you're now relieved.
Yes. That's okay. It, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, so sino pa mag-volunteer? Parang wala na mag-volunteer, ha?
I think Daniel J. Navarro would like to volunteer. He's raising his hand.
Okay, okay, sige.
His virtual hand.
Okay, sige. Daniel Navarro, can you turn on your camera, please?
Okay, sir. What am I doing?
All you can see is a black. Ayan. Oh, okay. Daniel, you're there. All right, so again, Daniel, please tell us about yourself.
Okay. So I also feel nervous, but I think that I might as well make the most out of this seminar or webinar. So here okay. I go. So I'm Daniel J. Navarro, a fourth-year marketing management student.
All right, so why sorry.
Okay.
You want to continue? Sige.
No, I don't want to continue.
Okay. Sige, why marketing management?
So here's why I chose my course. There was a time when I watched a video online and I was fascinated because the content of that video or the creator of the video was some other person who was not really known, but it was showcased by a page with a much higher likes compared to the creator of the video, and it went viral. So at that moment, I thought that, oh, I want to be the guy that allows other people to be highlighted or to be showcased. And that's when I thought, nah, I want to be a marketer because I want to work at the sidelines while making or showcasing something that is not yet that known. That's what I want to do. I want to showcase others and stay at the sidelines or at the shadows.
Behind the scene, something like
that. Yes, yes.
All right. Sige. Okay. So this one, first question for you, Danielle. Mm-hmm. So how do you deal with pressure or stressful situation?
Most of the time when I feel pressured or stressed, it's because I'm not doing work. Like, I hate to be stagnant. I want to continuously have progress in my life. So when I am in a situation where I feel stressed because of lots of schoolwork, I just do it. That's what I do. I just do it, get progress, and feel better right afterwards.
All right. So yun, you keep on doing those things, no, that makes you stress or something
yes.
like that.
Yes. Okay.
So it's that's your mechanism.
Yeah, it's a way to, like, if you immerse yourself on something, like, expose yourself to what is in danger or, like, like uncomfortable situations, you build an immunity to it or a tenacity towards it. All That's right. how people grow.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so if you will be hired, what would be your first 30, 60, and 90 days look like in this role?
So for the first 30 days, I would just continuously learn, like watch people around me, how they do their stuff, make acquaintances with everyone. For the 60 to 90 days, that's when I'll try to build or like make experimentations. Like I will find a way to know the best practices for my role, implement efficient practices and like a trial and error experiment so that I will continuously get better and more efficient in what I will do.
Okay. So what people, so from other generations, should understand from today's generation?
That's quite an interesting question because...
Yeah.
I don't really identify myself in a generational matter, but generally speaking, I want people to have this kind of mindset to like try to be more open-minded on the quirks and features of other people. So rather than making it as a generational advice, I would make it as a more general advice. So just try to be open-minded and understand what other people might think. Put yourself always on other people's shoes before you interact with them or before you say something, and just like think That's my 2 cents on this.
Okay. So what do you think are the most important characteristics and abilities a person must possess to become successful? How would you rate yourself in these areas?
Okay. So I think the most important thing is to be hardworking and to be risk averse and not easily be downtrodden by failure. So as long as you keep moving forward, surely there will come a time when you would be successful. It doesn't matter how much you fail, because that one victory or that one success will be all that matters. For me, I have joined quite a lot of competitions. I have joined YSEAL, Innovation Olympics, and the Holt Prize. So prior to entering those competitions, our team have failed a lot of times, and it was quite disheartening. But every time we have failed, we applied the lessons from our failure, and going on from there, we have finally succeeded, and we have finally succeeded and won some of the competitions that we have attended. And doing all those hard work and continuing on despite of the failures, I can say that the experience was truly worth it.
So with those characteristics that you've mentioned, how would you rate yourself in those areas?
I don't really care about failing. I just want to do things and gauge myself, like how I would be able to. I just want to do things to gauge myself and my capability. So I don't really care about what other people would think as long as I am improving. So I think I fare on a higher scale when it comes to being risk averse, being hardworking, and being not afraid of failure. I rate myself 8 out of 10. All right.
8 out of 10. All right. So thank you so much, Daniel.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
All
right.
So who's
Meron.
Next?
Sir Benji? Meron pa ba? Meron hinahanap ng mga students pero parang wala naman dito.
Okay, search natin, sir. Anong name?
Is Rachel here?
Rachel?
Rachel ba to? Kalimus pangalan. So, psychology ata yung course, Ani.
Okay, how about Ann Cabillo? Can you open your camera, please?
Oh, babae naman, babae.
Okay, Ms. Cabillo, are you there?
We still have questions pa.
Training ground lang yun ito, guys.
Ay, si ano na lang, oh.
Sige, wala.
Eh? Si Kuan. AJ, agad?
Agad, sir.
Yeah, si AJ.
Okay.
AJ, okay. Are you there?
AJ, can you open your camera, please?
Wala man si AJ.
At least I gusto mag-take a risk, sir Benji.
Take a... Ah, si Trisha na lang, oh. Trisha and Francisco.
Sige.
Trisha, turn on your mic.
Hi, sir. Good afternoon.
Yeah, yan.
Can you turn your camera, please?
Hey, sir. Hi, sir. Good afternoon.
Hi, good afternoon, Trish. How are you today?
Well, I'm doing fine, sir.
All right. So kindly introduce yourself.
So good afternoon, everyone. I am Trisha Ann A. Francisco, 21 years old, from College of Business Administration Education, fourth year human resource management student.
Oh, human resource. Okay. So why human resource?
First of all, human resource is not really my choice course, because since senior high school, I've been into ABM, which is accounting business management. So my dream course is actually accountancy. But unfortunately, my friends, they actually told me that I should pursue HR because HR is for leaders. And I do believe that I have the passion in becoming a leader.
Oh, okay. Okay, so assume that you are, you know, pursuing a certain job, I mean position, an entry-level position. Okay, so here's your question. Okay, so as a leader, you know, how would you handle it if your boss was wrong?
Well, currently I have a job as a customer representative in technical solutions. And sometimes you have conversations with my manager. And sometimes I don't disagree with his ideas. And with that, I used to communicate because I know communication is the key. And actually through communication with him, he actually understands my ideas and my, you know, my opinions towards if he is wrong, because actually he has trust in me and what the words I say. Just that, try to communicate if your boss is wrong and then educate them.
If your boss, you know, will insist that his mindset or his idea is correct, even though for you it's wrong, how would you handle that?
Well, I would respect his decision because he is higher position than me, but I would also let him realize that maybe in time you would also understand why I also said that opinion to my boss.
All right. So is there something good that you can say about the pandemic?
Oh, yes, of course. Pandemic has been an opportunity for me. Since college, I've been a scholar in our university for cultural events. But unfortunately, during the pandemic, our scholarship was not granted. It was not extended. So I've been into a stressful days because where would I got my scholarship? But through this pandemic, it has given me the opportunity to have my job as a call center agent. And also it has given me the opportunity to apply for a scholarship in Shed. In that way, pandemic is become something good to me.
All right. So I think that's it. Thank you so much, Risha.
Thank you, sir.
All right.
Thank you, okay. Sir Benji. Hindi ka na magtanong ng iba.
Wala na. Tapos na kasi.
Baka mayroon ka pang gusto tawagin or what?
Wala na. Wala na kasi. Wala ng, ano, wala ng questions.
Okay. Let's proceed.
Alright. So, just to give some ano discussion, no, with regards to other question. Okay, so this one, how would you handle if no, it bus was wrong? So I would also agree, no, with Trisha that you can also actually give, no, like what's your opinion to that? No, but of course, if your boss will really insist, no, he's a boss, so you still have to respect that one. Okay, so what people from other generations should understand from today's generation. So it's very important, no, that the other generation should understand, no, what's the capacity, you know, you as kanang karunan generation, because you are very exposed, like we are very exposed to technology, and that becomes our advantage because, diba, this generation sinasabing tamad, there are negative parang connotation with this generation, but what the other generation should understand, no, na this generation is very technical, no, and good into multitasking. So that's actually the advantage, no, of this generation. Na dapat ma-understand nila. So this one, if you will be hired, what would be your first 30, 60, 90 days? Now, of course, not. Ito, it's like a honeymoon period, no, na kailangan mo maintindihan that once mapunta ka sa trabaho, that, like alam mo na lahat. No, it's not like that. no, meron talagang honeymoon period, no, wherein in 30 days, no, you would you have to know what's your work, no, what's your job description, and then 60 days it would talk about your relations, no, with your mga kasama, no, and then 90 days within the 3 months siguro, I think you will be able to know what are the things that you have to do, no, in your work, no. So para alam mo na how to deal, no, with the people around you and even the work that you have. So ganun. So this one, no, it's very important also that we have this what we call mechanism in terms of stressful situation. Because definitely there will be things, no, sa work, no, na magiging stress ka, maraming deadlines, no, but then it's very important, no, na meron tayong ways and means in order for us to de-stress and to relax and be able to yung parang mag-isip on how to deal this pressure in life, especially if you have pressure sa imuhang family, sa work, and even personal of you. So, di ba part ng professional goals natin is yung personal satisfaction. Oh, there's a need for us to have those goals, no, ano kayang ways and means ko, no, na to, in order for me to relax and to eradicate stressful situations sa life ko. So, ang iba, di ba, they want to read books. Once they are stressed, they want to read books. Di kaya uban, kay mo at to coffee shop, or something like that. So, you have to have that one, no, para maging comfortable ka and be able to gain energy for you to be able to overcome na naman, no, those things that you have to set, no, sa trabaho mo. Okay. Okay, this one. So, impressive credentials and good years of experience. So, di ba, usahay, di ba, muna itong kahadlukan kay, di ba, kita, entry level, no, fresh graduate. But then again, that's actually an advantage. No, bakit? Kasi, for other boss, ikaw yung tao na learn, willing to learn. No, kasi nga, yung madami mga experience na, they have na, parang this capacity to be proud of themselves na, I can do that. I'm better than that. I'm better than the person na nasa position. So, but what is good is that once advantage mo, no, as an entry level, you have that attitude that you want to learn. You have that motivation, diba, that you really want to get the job. So that becomes, no, your advantage. So even though they have impressive credentials, do not be afraid of that. No, kasi nga, you have also the capacity, you are new. So that means na you have that willingness and you're open to learning. Okay. So how many hours a week do you usually work and why? So this talks about, diba, your commitment to your work. No, are you willing to go beyond hours, no, of working in order na matapos mo yung work mo? So it's also important also that you can tell that to during the job interview na you're willing, no, to have that kanang parang go beyond, no, the hours na needed for your work, no, if it is necessary for the project ba, no, or the work na kailangan. So this talks about your commitment. So if you're an animal, so yun, what is good is that when Nasram answered this one, hindi lang siya nag-focus doon sa anong character, but he also incorporated it to his position na gusto niyang applyan. So dapat meron talaga yan, relate mo talaga yan siya. Okay, so ito din ng mga questions, di ba, parang ano to siya, they're making assessment in terms of your personality, no, as a person. Okay, this one. If you had to live your life over again, what one thing would you change? So it's very important that we accept, no, our weakness or our failures or parang it's your mistakes, diba? Like every one of us naman has mistakes in life. We just have to accept that one. Kasi if you would say that there's no thing palang wala kang i-change, no, sa life mo, no, it leads to perfection. No, at some point it interprets that you're very proud. So parang ganun ba? No. But it's very important also to accept na meron ba talaga tayong mga failures. But how did you overcome, no, those failures? How did you change that one? Yun yung gustong i-emphasize dito. So you can emphasize that one, like for example, you have problems in terms of a situation or you want to change a situation na nangyari sa life mo, like in your previous work, you have problems in terms of punctuality. So how did you change that one in order to become a better person? So parang ganun. So it's very important also to accept that we have mistakes and we are not perfect. God, this one, I like the answer of Eman, because he was not able to give, no, yung parang a fixed amount, no, kasi mababox in ka kasi once you give an amount. Like for example, you say 15,000, but what if the company will say we cannot give you that one, 10,000 lang kaya namin, or more than pa pala ng 15,000 ang kaya nila. So I like the answer of Eman, not bringing not kanang giving a certain amount, but instead kanang parang gipaganahan ng company, your company is like this and like that, or parang ganun. Or even tell them na I believe that the company is adhering to the Department of Labor and Employment ng mga rules in terms of salary, that you give above minimum, so I also deserve that one, and based on my experiences, no, and my qualification, no, I believe that I can have, no, the appropriate salary for the position, something like that. So better na dili maghatag og amount, yung fixed amount, kasi ma-box in ka eh. So this one, that's why very important, no, that we recognize or even participate, no, ourselves to a lot of activities in college, not just academic, but also yung mga extracurricular, because that becomes your kanang parang experience mo, how to really sell yourself, no? So kung daghang kag experience, no, during your college, so mas dali nimo ma-introduce imo ang self because of those experiences. Not just here inside sa university, but even those activities that you had, no, outside, no, that help you grow as a person. So I think, no, yun lang yung mga questions. Okay, so this one, this is actually a ang ginagawa natin. So hopefully others also can join with this. So we will just announce, no, kailan yung yung career fair natin. No, wherein you'll be exposed to different parang industries. Industries ninyo. No, wherein an HR, no, will interview you, no? And then ibang bibigay sila ng mga critic or evaluation towards your interview. So ito siya. So for how many attempts natin from 2016 until right now 2020, so nag-increase naman, no, yung ano natin, yung progress in terms of your verbal at saka non-verbal behavior niyo during the job interview. So yung threshold natin is actually 4, but merong recent niyan, no, but in that survey, so makita natin, 'di ba, isa sa mga nakpuna, no, ng mga HR this some point, no, may failure in terms of listening closely to questions. So you have to listen really carefully to the question, kung ano ba yung gist talaga ng question, so that you can give answer. Wag masyado generic, you know, try to be specific in terms of your answer, kasi naman it's a job interview, wala naman siyang time limit. So unlike mga Miss Universe, so maano ninyo na generic talaga yung answers nila, kay you will only be given 30 seconds to answer. So how can you really kanang parang create answers for that? But in terms of job interview, wala naman siyang time limit. So we have to listen closely to the question and then internalize the question so that you can give, no, answers to that. Okay? Then thank the interviewer for their time. Oh, isa pala yung na observe. So do not leave the room without asking a question to the interviewer. So dapat mag-ask yun og answer a question. So basin nag-isog, thank you very much. But then have the privilege, I have the kaparang authority, no, to really ask questions. So what questions will you give, yung mga about sa in terms of trainings, no, or naghahatag ba sila og like mga scholarships, no, if you want to pursue graduate studies, mga perks nila, or something like that. Okay, another is focus on strengths, avoided weaknesses. So as I mentioned kanina, so not just your strengths but also your weaknesses, you can also tell that one, no, we have to accept, no, that we have weaknesses in life, but then how did you overcome those weaknesses that you have and you made it as your strengths? And then ask appropriately questions to the interviewer. So yun. And then avoid use of fillers or empty words. So practice tayo niyan. Like even I, no, meron kang mga ano, no? So practice lang, no? How to overcome those fillers. So let's avoid that one in order for, no, our interviewer to be able to understand, no, the point that we have. Kasi baka all throughout your interview, na lang yun, iba nakit na napaminawan. So the answer to the question, nawala na siya. Ayan. So isa yan sa mga ginagawa natin for you na no, nakasali, na tapos na ang ka-ed, saka graduating. So you just wait for the announcement, kailan yan, and grab that opportunity, no, para mahasa pa ang inyong job interview skills. So whether you like it or not, job interview is part of the process. So we have to parang harness our skill in terms of that kind of activity, no, to get the job that you want to. Okay. Okay, so here's the last quote, no, for this talk of survey. So we look for three things when we hire people. We look for intelligence, we look for initiative or energy, and we look for integrity. And if they don't have the latter, the first two will kill you. Because if you're going to get someone without integrity, you want them lazy and dumb. So don't forget, no, to have these three things, the intelligence, no, the initiative or the inner energy, and also that integrity. Integrity is very important, diba? In order for us to be parang trustworthy, no, to the position that we have. Intelligence also is very important. No? That's why ganin, why we have these degree courses, no, in order for us, no, once nandun na tayo sa position, alam natin yung gagawin natin because we have been trained for how many years, no, for that course. And of course, the initiative and your motivation, no, the energy, no, to your passion, no, for that position, no, na gusto mo in that certain industry. So yun. Okay, I think that's it. Okay, so baka mayroon kayong questions or clarifications that you want to say based on the presentation of Sir Reha. Later na siguro yung mga about sa mga ano ninyo, mga clarification with activities and others, because Sir Marvin will give some inputs on that. Baka meron kayong gusto i-ask regarding sa presentation.
So, is there any clarifications or questions? You can raise your hands now. None?
Okay, wala naman na siguro,
so,
sir.
Wala man dyan. So, can I just screen share, Sir Benji?
Ha?
Screen share, so.
As again, go. Hey. So many.
So this is just only a reminder, class.
Stop share. Okay, sige, sir, go.
So reminders lang. So, valid concerns shall be raised ahead of time, and any lacking requirements of each component will be graded 7.2. So, inform lang ahead of time if you got 7.2 para di kayo mapaso sa registrar. The next. Culmination day will be on October 6, 2021 via Zoom. And then, sorry, I forgot to change the time for the mock interview. So the mock interview also will be on October 1, 2021. Whole day ni siya. So kayo yung pipili ng schedule ninyo, morning or afternoon session. So we'll be giving you a link of form sa link sa inyong LMS. Para doon kayo magpili o mag-pick ng inyong schedule sa inyong mock interview. So again guys, we are encouraging everyone na mag-join sa interview, especially yung mga teacher HR natin, para talaga ma-train kayo. Okay?
But of course, if you're not ready for a virtual mock interview, we have, okay, ano naman, another option for you guys.
Yung sabi namin is yung TikTok. So you can also choose between the mock interview or the TikTok. And then also the job interview attire. And then winners sa raffle, yung mga nag-like sa YouTube natin. So will be announced on October 6 also, right after the talk sa tuang speaker. So we will be choosing two winners, each coach. So dalawa kay Sir Benji, dalawa kay Ma'am May, dalawa sa akin, pero kay Ma'am Isa isa lang because isa lang yung code niya. So we will be announcing that on October 6. Live po tayo. So para walang tikas, kumbaga. So you have any questions or clarifications?
So just to add up lang dun sa announcement ni Sir Marvin with regards yung dalawang choices niyo. So again, if you want to have experience that virtual mock interview, so we will be putting forms, no? Ay parang link, no, for anong schedule niyong gusto. So you can still choose whether on the morning ba or the afternoon kayo pwede. So kasi meron kayong mga classes. But then if you're not ready for that virtual mock interview na parang one-on-one talaga na interview with the interviewer, you can join the TikTok challenge na wherein you're going to make a video of the job interview attire and also the job interview challenge wherein you're going to have a duet with your coach. No, meron siyang lalagay na question and then you have an answer. So to that question, mag-duet. So I think you know that one. Kala mga TikToker, dira. So at least, no, kung dili pa kayo mo confident for that, no, so you can have the TikTok.
Okay. And then just a heads up lang guys. Sa mga mag-interview lang, hindi lang kami yung mag-interview, yung mga coaches ninyo. And we invite HR practitioners talaga outside ng UM na mag-try og interview sa inyo, ha. So training lang talaga siya. So huwag kayong kabahan or huwag kayong huwag kayong hesitant na mag-take sa risk na mag-undergo sa mock interview challenge. Via Zoom lang din naman. Okay,
so other information, lalagay lang naman siya sa LMS. So you coordinate with your coaches na for other things na i-require nila sa inyo for the CAED 500. Other clarifications? Baka meron pa clarifications before we will end our session?
So none? Parang konti na lang tayo from 150 plus naging 124 na Sir Benji.
Okay, sige. I would just like to give applause, no, sa ating mga nag-volunteer ngayon at saka vinolunteer ko. Walang thank you very much, no. Grabe kay competitive kaayo.
Grabe mga bright man jud kay sila.
Mo siguro nahadlok ang uban, no, wala na nanulod.
Pangkaon-kaon naman mga English.
All right. So, okay. So Sir Marvs,
there's no concerns or clarification. So with that, let's call it a day. So thank you everyone. So have a great day. Keep safe.
Bye everyone. Sa may bardagulan, habing siyang pagwalang labing walo.